Good morning, students. In the last time, we have discussed about the electrolysis of acidified water, right? Today, we are going to discuss about the electrolysis of copper sulfate solution using platinum anode and copper or a platinum cathode, right? In my book, it is on page number 112. So it must be around 111 or 110 page number in your notebook, in your book, sorry. So moving on, this time, you need to learn the colors of the electrolysis product as well. They come in the question paper. See, this chapter is not that easy as you must be thinking. This chapter is a bit difficult chapter and you need to revise and learn it thoroughly for giving the test. I have been searching the questions about the important questions, and all were very difficult questions, so you need to work very hard on this chapter. So let's start about the electrolysis of copper sulfate. Right, in copper sulfate there are two ions. When you will mix it in water, there will be two molecules, that is H2O and copper sulfate. When you will dissolve copper sulfate, it will dissociate and will form Cu positive, 2 positive, and SO4, 2 negative. Similarly, H2O will break into H positive plus OH negative ion. Right. Now, what will happen? As in my previous lecture, I have explained you about the reactivity of electrochemical series of positive ions, metals, as well as for non-metals. On that, if you will go through it, you will find that copper has more electrode potential, has more reduction potential as compared to H plus ion. Copper has more reduction potential as compared to H plus ion. So definitely out of these two, if you haven't watched my video, previous video, this will be very much difficult for you to understand. So you need to understand it very clearly. First of all, go through my previous video, then only you will be able to understand this. Out of these two ions, copper will prefer to go at cathode. The reaction of cathode will be Cu2 positive plus 2 electrons gives copper. Right. This is a reddish pink color, pink or reddish brown color, right? You will observe that reddish or pink or reddish brown color, pink or reddish brown color will deposit on cathode. Now move on to the reaction of anode. Well, what will be the reaction of anode? See here, in the case of anode, we have two ions, OH negative ion and SO4 2 negative ion. We have two ions, OH negative ion and SO4 2 negative ion. As I explained you that sulfate has less oxidation potential as compared to OH negative ion. SO4 2 negative has less reduction potential as compared to OH negative ion. So the equation will form as 4OH gives 2H2O plus O2. This will be the equation. Oxygen gas will be released at anode, right? Anode, you will find a release of oxygen gas, and at cathode you will find a reddish brown color or a pink color get deposited at cathode. You need to learn the colors as well, right? So the moment when all the anode will deposit at, sorry, all the copper will deposit at cathode, the moment when all the copper will deposit at cathode, after that the electrolysis of water will take place, right? After that, when all the copper will deposit at cathode, after that the deposition of hydrogen gas will start taking place. After that, hydrogen, once it will get completed, after that the reaction of H plus ion. What will be the reaction of H plus ion at cathode? What will be the reaction? 2H positive plus 2 electron gives H2 gas. So once when this reaction will get completed, after that this reaction will start taking place. So you can see that in case of copper sulfate, after some time hydrogen gas will deposit at cathode and oxygen gas will deposit at anode. Correct? Now, moving to the next part, that is electrolysis of aqueous copper sulfate using copper electrodes. You can see here, electrolysis of aqueous copper sulfate using copper electrodes. Students, you need to pay attention in this electrolysis because there is a twist in this reaction. What you will see that here, what is taken, first of all, consider it in the copper sulfate solution. Both are copper rods. In copper sulfate solution, cathode is also made up of copper rod and anode is also made up of copper rod. In the previous diagram, I will explain it to you like this. Yes, in the previous one of the rod might can made from copper, that is cathode, or platinum, but the other is anode is made up of platinum. This is the reason why oxygen get deposited on anode when anode is taken as platinum rod. But if you will take, in this case you can see that both the rods are made up of copper. So again, what will happen, I will write the two equations. Let me write it. Again, same thing will happen for electrolysis of copper sulfate. We will write the two equations, one for H2O and one for copper sulfate. Okay. What will happen in case of cathode? In case of cathode, the reaction will occur same. This will be the same reaction. The reaction at cathode will be the same reaction. But what will happen in case of anode? This reaction won't take place because the rod is of platinum. But when you will take the rod as copper, when there is copper rod, then what will be the reaction at anode? The same reaction will take place in the reverse direction. That means copper gives copper 2 positive plus 2 electrons. The same reaction will occur in the reverse direction. Means at cathode there is a gain of electron, at anode there is loss of electron. Right? You can write it like this or like this. Cu minus 2 electron gives Cu 2 positive. Here it is clearly showing that loss of electron is taking place. So you can see the contradictory statements. What is happening in case of anode, when they have taken platinum rod, then oxygen gas is liberated. But in case when they have taken anode as copper rod, then no product will be formed because anode will keep on dissolving. This rod will keep on dissolving and become iron. What will happen? See, if this is cathode and this is anode, consider it as anode. So in the first case, you will observe the gaseous particles, gases, bubbles coming out from anode as oxygen gas is liberated. Right? As oxygen gas is liberated, you can see that the bubbles will come out from anode. But in case of this, in case of copper rod, what you will see that here, what will happen from the copper ion in case of cathode, this is anode. In case of cathode, you will observe that the rod atoms are going. The atoms from the copper rod is merging and becoming a solution. This is copper ion and this is copper rod. So the atom is dissolving into iron. They are coming towards this electrolyte and they will dissolve it. And in case of anode, this ions get associated, accumulate into a rod, an anodic rod. So after some time you will see that cathode will become thin and anode will become thick. Cathode will become thin. Why? Because the atoms are going into the electrolyte. Atoms are dissolving into the electrolyte. And anode will become thick. Why? Because the electrolyte is forming atoms and is depositing at cathode, anode, right? Now product at cathode, what will be the product at cathode? Pinkish or reddish brown copper is deposited, correct? Now moving on, students, this is, I'm so sorry, I have written it incorrectly. See, in anode there is loss of electrolytes. So this is anode and this is cathode. I'm so sorry, by mistake I have written it. It is very obvious that you can observe that anode, there is loss of electron takes place, that is copper is converting into copper ion. So this is copper rod and copper rod is converting into copper ion, which is happening, which this process is going on in anode, right? So it is clear that this is anode, and in cathode copper is depositing copper ion, from the ion it is converting into copper atom. So it is basically depositing at cathode, it is depositing, right? So you will observe that the rod, cathodic rod, in the cathodic rod you will observe that the pink or reddish brown color will obtain, will be deposited at cathode, pink or reddish brown color will be deposited, correct? Now I would like to tell you that first of all today I'll discuss Agrini ma'am about the students who are not responding me, right? Students, this is in my book, it is on page number 108, the in-text questions. You need to do all the in-text questions, you need to solve all the in-text questions yourself. The in any question, if you feel any problem, then you can ask me, but you, this is your homework, that you need to solve all the in-text questions. The questions of this chapter are not easy, I'm telling again and again, the chapter is not easy as what you people must be expecting. This chapter is a bit difficult chapter. It is not like the previous chapters. Now you need to revise this chapter. You need to do questions based on in-text question of this on the page number 114, right? You need to do this as well. This will definitely come in your test. You need to learn and write all these questions by yourself, right? I need both the in-text questions from homework, right? I need to the work done on time. No need to do fill in the blanks in the notebook, just do it in your book only and try to do this. Explain the following, these are most important questions, you need to do all these questions. Moving on to the other topic, that is application of electrolysis. What are the importance? What is the importance of electrolysis and how we can use electrolysis in our day-to-day life? So first of all, it is used for electroplating, the other is electrorefining, and third is extraction for metals, of metals, that is electrometallurgy. Correct. Now what happens in electroplating? Electroplating is basically like you have seen almirahs at your home, you must all have almirah at your home, and that almirah must be colored, right? No one have that iron colored almirah which looks shabby as well. Generally it is used as electroplating is used for a decoration purpose, but electroplating is like see, this is a metal. I will tell you the process of electroplating. What happens in case of electroplating? Consider it as anode, and this is an iron object. This is our iron object, right? Iron rod. I need to electroplate it. Electroplate is like plating, very small plating of some other more reactive metal. When I'll plate it, when I'll cover this rod with a more reactive element, then what will happen? The atmospheric oxygen and the atmospheric water vapors will react with the more electronegative metal as compared to the iron. So our iron will not get rust, right? It will not affected by the atmospheric oxygen. It will not be eaten up by atmospheric oxygen or water. This process is known as electroplating, right? By electroplating, one can prevent the articles made up of iron or like that. What happens basically, we just put a tiny layer, a very thin layer of other metal which are more reactive. Okay, how we do it now? If you will see how we do it electroplating, how we do it. Like if I'll electroplate the iron object with zinc. If I'll electroplate the iron object with zinc metal, then how we do? We put iron rod as cathode, we consider it as cathode. And what will happen? See, if this is an electrolyte made up of zinc sulfate, right? Then what happens? What will happen? At cathode, the reaction will occur as gain of electron. Zinc ion will take two electrons. Zinc ion, this zinc sulfate will get dissociated and will form zinc ion. This zinc ion will take two electrons and become as zinc. They will deposit at cathode. So a single metal is depositing at cathode. You can observe that how thin that plate will be when a single atom is depositing at cathode. So that plate will be very thin. You cannot make that thin plate by simply painting, because while painting there are millions of atoms which are overlapped, which are one after another in a layer only. But here, by electroplating only a very thin layer, thin plate of atom, like a single atom or two, three atoms one upon another can come. So this is known as electroplating. Now what is the use of electroplating? Electroplating, see, for example, this is your article made up of iron, right? And you have covered it with zinc atoms. It is covered with zinc atoms. Now what will happen if there is a scratch comes in the zinc atom? See, there is a scratch, right? Here, yahan par aapka zinc atom nahi hai. Here there is no zinc atom. So iron is coming directly in contact with air. This part of the iron object is coming directly in contact with air. The rest of the part is electroplated by zinc. Only this layer get broken up. ठीक है, ये लेयर आपका उखड़ गया है एंड ऑन दिस लेयर देयर इज नो जिंक. देन व्हाट विल हैपन? विल द आयरन फॉर्म रस्ट? क्या इस पर्टिकुलर पार्ट पे रस्टिंग हो जाएगी? देयर ऑब्वियसली हो जाएगी. जब यहाँ पर जिंक है ही नहीं, व्हेन देयर इज नो जिंक ऑन दिस एरिया, देन डेफिनेटली एयर इज गोइंग एंड ऑक्सीजन इज गोइंग टू अटैक ऑन दिस एरिया एंड विल ईट अप द आयरन. बट इट डज नॉट हैपन्स. Why? Even when the layer of the zinc get broken, even after that the iron cannot be eaten up by atmospheric oxygen or atmospheric water. Why is that? Because see, oxygen has to attack. Okay, now if oxygen has two options, one to attack on the iron and the other to attack on the zinc. One to attack on the iron and the second option is to attack on the zinc. Then which metal will be preferred by oxygen? Definitely the one which is more reactive. And out of iron and zinc, it is said that zinc is more reactive. Then what will happen? This zinc will attack this oxygen. The oxygen, atmospheric oxygen, will attack the zinc which is on the rest of the part of the on the article of the iron. Definitely oxygen is going to attack on the other part of the body, not on that particular body. So this is how your iron object get saved, even after when there is no layer of zinc. Then also it prevents the rusting of iron. Okay, now conditions of electroplating. This is your homework. Read yourself, try to do it yourself. Now moving on to the electroplating on article with silver. How do you electroplate the article with silver? The same happens in case of silver, as I have explained you in the example of zinc or iron. The same happens in case of silver. Let's read it. See what happens if you need to electroplate. See, let's consider that this is a spoon made up of brass. Right, this brass spoon has to be electroplated with silver. Electroplating means to deposit uniformly a thin layer of silver. We need to deposit it. we need to electroplate it, kind of paint it. A very thin layer is painted with the help of electroplating. So we need to add silver atoms on the surface of the spoon. What will we do? First of all, we will wash it thoroughly. How will we wash it? By first passing it to hot caustic soda. Caustic soda is basically sodium hydroxide. Is caustic soda. Caustic soda is basically sodium hydroxide. Okay, it is used in washing white clothes, and if taken in the concentrated form, then it can even torn up the clothes, tear up, fat jayega aapka kapda. So you need to take it in a very small concentration, dilute concentration. So first silver brass spoon is washed with caustic soda, then is passed with hydrochloric acid and water. After that, it is thoroughly washed with detergent so that all the dust and the other atoms or the silver oxide is the black layer which get deposited on the silver layer. Have you seen mama's pajeb? Everyone's mother must be wearing payal or pajeb, what we call it as anklets, right? So after some time they become black in color. Why? Because a layer of silver oxide get formed on it, on the surface of silver. So it becomes blackish in color. The silver oxide is black in color. So this is the reason we want to remove we need to remove all the impurities from the surface of this brass so that no impurity can attack on this brass spoon, and we can directly put the layer of silver. So what happened? First we'll thoroughly wash the brass spoon, and then what will we do? We will put it as a cathode. We will consider it as cathode. Okay, after this we will take a pure block of silver and consider it as anode. An electrolyte of sodium argentocyanide, this is the chemical formula of sodium argentocyanide, or potassium argentocyanide is taken as electrolyte. So when you will deposit electrolyte, it will get, how to make a sodium argentocyanide? By taking silver nitrate and sodium cyanide and then reacting it with sodium cyanide in excess, then you can form as sodium argentocyanide. Now what will happen when argentocyanide, sodium argentocyanide is taken as a electrolyte, then what will happen? On dissolving it in water, it will get dissociated. And will form silver ion, sodium ion and cyanide ion. So we will have silver ions as an electrolyte. Now what will we do? We will take the atoms from anode and we will dissolve that atoms in the electrolyte. The same amount of atoms, at the same time, the same amount of ions will get deposited on the cathode. Let me draw it and make it myself. What will happen? See, this is your spoon. Okay, this is your spoon and this is a silver block. What will you do? You have silver with as an electrolyte and this is pure silver rod as anode. Now what will happen when you will take this spoon as cathode? Now what will happen? See, a moment when they will get connected with a battery or with an ammeter as well. What will happen? Some of the atoms will start depositing and forming as ions. Sodium is silver ions. At anode, the reaction will occur that the silver will start depositing, will start losing the electron from anode and will form silver ion with the loss of electron. The same amount of ions will start depositing at cathode. They will take ion which is they will take iron from electrolyte and will accept electron from anode and will form silver atoms towards cathode, which will be uniformly distributed. This is how electroplating is done. This is how the process of electroplating is carried out, right? You need to learn all the reactions. I'm repeating it again and again. The chapter is not that much easy as it is seeming. You need to learn all the reactions. You need to do all the questions at your homework, at yourself. Now, you will say that, ma'am, there might be the question that, ma'am, how much thickness, what will be the thickness of this silver on deposited on this cathode, on this spoon? How much thick will be the silver that will deposit on the cathode rod? So, it totally depends upon the charge passed, upon the current passed. The more you will pass the current, the more thicker will be the coating of silver. The less current you will pass, the less will be the coating of silver, right? And okay, apart from this, let's move on to the electroplating of nickel, electroplating with nickel, or we will discuss it later on. Today I have given you a lot of homework. What you need to do is try to do all the in-text questions. All the in-text questions try to do yourself and also do it as homework. I will check each and every's question homework, and those who have not completed homework, I'll ask with ma'am, your class teacher. First of all, I'm going to ask, only very few of the students are in contact with me. Rest of the students, I don't know where they are, what are they doing. So I'll first contact with your class teacher, okay? Try to do the homework. This is the end of today's lecture. Thank you very much. God bless you.